say, okay, we can date now. We can, because it's the way I'm trying to say this. It's like, oh no, y'all claim that we switch up. That's what it is. It's like y'all switch up, not y'all though. Cause mm-hmm. I don't want to say y'all, but me and switch up when they realize, right, oh, right. She really like me now.
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah. See, look now. That's a variation, like a, it varies the answer to this question. Mm-hmm. Like it's all type of scenarios that a man can find himself in that'll go, holy shit, I am afraid, or I wasn't planning for this to move maybe too fast on their part. Like it's so much different shit that could be going on in a man's brain to go, oh my God, and then you kind of start acting weird because it's not really what it was before, because maybe you're trying to work your way out of it because it's still kind of in the early stages, so you just maybe, and it, you see the adjustments to their behavior. So it's, like I said, it kind of all depends on what the man is doing.
I feel like it's both.
What you mean? Because it's more than just one, two things.
That's true. That's true. A bunch. Because I feel like, I'm going to just give you an example. I'm not going to say no name. Okay.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
I've actually dated a guy.
Please don't.
That was my friend. And I told him off rip, like, look here, we're friends. Because that's what I do with all guy friends. I let them know ahead of time.
You got it.
Because you know some women don't.
You got
it. You know?
Yeah.
I will let you know off rip. And you will know if I like you because I'll be flirting. I'll be, you know. But if I'm keeping it friendly, right? And then I all of a sudden be like, you know, I do actually got a little, you know, I'm starting to like you over time. You're not going to switch up and just be like, why? Because I'm your friend, right? But that's the thing. Some guys ain't even your friend in the beginning. They be faking it the whole time.
All right.
So, that's where the switch up come from, because I feel like if you was really her friend, you're not going to switch up.
Okay. All right. So, I got you. I see where you really coming from here. Mm-hmm. All right. So, here's the whole deal with most fucking guys. I think I'm not particularly sure.
Okay.
I don't want to say that every man in the world is going to be thinking like this, but most guys, they get into a stage where it's like, okay, so check this out. Okay, check this out. So technically there's no friend zone. It don't exist.
Why doesn't it?
So no matter what a man says, if you're attractive, if you call this nigga 2 o'clock in the morning,
but
or
not.
Text him, and just said whatever. You can say whatever. And if you don't normally text that nigga at 2 a.m. because texting at 2 a.m. is some... You are initiating into some shit if you texting at 2 a.m. Don't do it if we friends. But at the same time, it's like...
Is it because of a woman being attractive?
Of course.
Because I feel like also, I feel like if y'all was never friends, why even?
So now,
okay,
we get into the bravery of men at times. Sometimes they enter into a relationship solely to try to be with the person.
Yes.
Sometimes, kind of like, I think even in the case of me and you, like, we got history. We know each other from kind of a long time ago. We kind of grew up together, and we are adults now. We was doing some of the same stuff as adults as far as music goes. It's just a bunch of similar interests that kind of kept us in each other's fucking range.
Right.
So
right.
It just is what it is, and it's going to be what it's going to be. So I know we're going to be around each other from time to time, and we're going to be doing similar things and different things like that. Whatever.
Right.
And vibes are vibes. That's not to, this is what it is. So that's why I'm going to say that my name is J Focuz, aka lover of the whole fucking game, because I love the motherfucking game, dog. And when I say the game, I mean the game of life. I'm here with
Briez. Bria, whatever you want to call me, Brie, I'm here.
And this is the Wake and Bake Podcast.
Hey.
Yeah. Close. Vilmatic. 1-1-1-1-1-2-1-1-2-1-1-2-1-1-2-1.
one. Okay. Listen, close. I stare at my dreams as they approach. Gotta be patient and trust in God, he the coach. Temptations are taking a shortcut, but I don't. Cause I ain't trying to be an almost. When I get it, I'm afloat. Gone are the days we was close. Now when I see you, I look at you just like a ghost. A shell of your former self, so caught up with that dope. Two niggas singing two different notes, and you know I got a coast. Nothing but a dollar and some hope. Up in the wide, but damn, what hurts me the most? You was a good nigga, we knew each other's folks. Now you gotta ride around with the toast, and you keep that shit close.
You mix with Dre, right? Turn headphones up.
When the whole world see you as Pac-Man incarnated, that's enough pressure to live your whole life sedated. Find the tallest building in Vegas and jump off it. But I can never rewrite history in the coffin. So I'm talking to God, can you wash all these demons off me? This last year been quite similar to a Lear. Control my own destiny, only rapper that steers. A G5, G's give high fives to me and say, Kendrick, just persevere. The presence of being...
Bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Maybe nothing too important. Maybe something detrimentally important. Maybe you need to hear this in order for you to continue to move forward in the way that you would like to. Maybe we say some real shit. I don't know. But anyway, Jason Derulo is punching niggas in the face for being called Usher. Gunna is shooting mediocre bars at Freddie Gibbs. Ye is taking Gap into high fashion with Balenciaga. And QC signs Detroit rapper Baby Money, another fucking baby in the game, this week in WNBP episode 47. This is going down. Now, I also heard that there was this podcast, The Word on the Block Is, and I really wish my co-host Bones was here, because... he is kind of familiar with the show as well, but recently it came out that their preference, it seems like to them, mm-hmm. is everything but black women.
Right.
I thought that was some weird shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, definitely. I don't really, if you got bad things to say, at least explain yourself. Like, you could say, hey, man, you know, I went through this, that, and the third. And maybe you can have a couple examples of why. But, like, even if you don't, like, if you can't have no explanation, then is it a preference?
Exactly.
Or are
exactly.
you just doing, like, some stereotyping type bullshit?
I don't know. I feel like they're using that as views to, you know, attract more people to their podcast. I feel like, you know, if you can sell something, sell it. I mean, and I feel like a lot of people don't like black women. So if I'ma say that shit, I could get all type of racist people. I could get all types of people that don't right. like black people or right. black women to come on my show to watch. Because guess what? They're gonna be waiting for me to talk about those black women.
But so see, I feel like here's that's the whole thing, doing. Though. He even getting them girls to come on the show. On the show, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. even post that. So it's kind of like, I get that you would like a platform for yourself mm-hmm. in order to be able to promote or whatever, but at the end of the day, without y'all, like, I wouldn't even clicked on one of the episodes without the girls. Like,
right, right.
I would have never clicked on one of them bitches, so that's, I'm like, that's some weird shit. I don't really understand.
I also noticed on his page, when you go to the fit and whatever the freak they shit called, I'm not about to promote they shit.
You have to. Right. And you know? I'm probably going to like mix whatever, if exactly. whatever I say intro in.
So, well, when I seen his videos, certain videos, his headlines are, I put ghetto women out or I put these ghetto girls out, and it's a picture of him putting dark-skinned women out at his show, and I kind of feel like that's what you want. You know, you want to attract that type of crowd, people that don't like black women. I mean, so I feel like, was he doing that for clout? Definitely. Do I care that he don't like black women or if that's his preference? I don't. It don't hurt me.
I think I'm going to call the podcast Two Doofies in Miami. Two really? Goofies in Miami.
Finish him.
But that's how it's going to go. So all we can do at this point is not give all of the energy that can be given mm-hmm. to this podcast. If you don't know what I'm talking about, do your Googles. You're not going to find out the name of that motherfucker from us. But it's a big deal right now.
Right.
Because podcasting is so new. Once we find somebody else that's kind of talking some bullshit, we kind of gravitate towards them in a way. But at the same time, that's what's giving it power, so you gotta kill the source of power, which is us.
Exactly.
So is what it is, man. I'm hoping motherfuckers can get off that bullshit, man, and just whatever you got to say about anything, race, color, whatever based, keep it to your fucking self. If you're not ready for the backlash, because when somebody catch you out in the streets, and this is not the internet, they catch you RIL, whatever the fuck, right. Niggas gonna smack the shit out your stupid ass, you're gonna be looking crazy.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So be prepared for what you say, man. This is the real world. And speaking on being prepared for what you say and the real world, contemporary R&B. Contemporary R&B, today's R&B and hip-hop are not different at all. They are synonymous with each other. It just seems like they're the same thing. They be on the same wave.
That's
my
true.
Bad. My bad. And,
that's true.
They all melodic, but and the current rappers are trying to, the R&B singers are trying to be oh so cool and laid back and nigga beg for her love, nigga. What the fuck is wrong with you, nigga?
Cry.
We need you on some motherfucking Temptations level. We about to Jodeci, go there. Come
okay?
on, man.
I need you on Drew Hill.
We about to take it. We need that from you niggas, bro. That's why the females is blowing these niggas out the water. The women know
bro,
how to get more
stop,
touch.
Stop calling me a bitch, okay?
It's
telling
very,
me to take off my clothes,
it's
okay?
A lot of very simple things you could do to improve your R&B, but it seems like the more further we've been getting in life, the more the rap has just been...
It's going down here.
The R&B has been trying to emulate it. I think mostly the men though. Oh, and that kind of that'll take me into a deep dark web of shit. But what do you think?
I feel like the reason they're taking this path, this route, is because they feel like this is what women want. I just feel like that. And the reason I feel like that is because, you know, certain women carry themselves a certain way and others don't. And I feel like you're gonna allow anybody to handle you the way you want them to handle you. I mean, so, and I feel like if a rapper or an R&B artist come to me rapping and oh, he look good, he got money, cause that's what we looking at. We're not looking at what he's, oh, we're not listening to what he's saying no more. We really just watching you. So if you come to me on some hood shit, so you ain't really gotta sing. You can say, bitch, take it off and fuck me right here. Da, 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 just we gonna instantly be like, because we seeing
that's
what you got.
What's portrayed out there.
Mm-hmm.
It is what's portrayed. Don't always tend to be the case, but you know.
But I feel like that's why they singing.
Yeah.
Rapping. Cause I,
right,
I think
sing
that's
rapping.
What, yeah, they sing
but
rapping.
See, okay, so look. All right, now, you done fucked up.
Yeah.
Hold on, wait. You done fucked up. That wasn't even meant to be the sound effect, but I didn't get it.
I like it though.
You actually have made me think about something I was thinking about maybe it was a month ago, maybe two. Mm-hmm. But I was sitting around thinking like everything according to physics technically is like reactionary.
Mm-hmm.
The universe wouldn't exist without something causing something to happen and the reaction being universal birth. That's just what people think.
Okay.
It's just common theory. So, does masculine toxicity come from somewhere? If so, where? What births it? I have what I think is the answer.
Okay, so give me your answer.
No.
And then I can.
No way.
No?
No way.
Why not?
Yeah, because it's too unique of a question. You really got to think about it. Don't
it. I have my answer. I just want to hear
yours.
Say
what you think.
Okay.
I want to hear yours. I came up with the question.
Okay. Where does it come from?
Yes. Where does it stem from? And kind of like, we going to keep it like more on like a general level.
Okay.
We don't really got to say that maybe it applies to every guy or girl or
exactly,
whatever.
Exactly, exactly.
The majority.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you got to say that one time for me.
So
where does it come from?
Where does masculine toxicity come from? Like they say that.
I want to say, I mean, what you mean? It comes from the man, I believe. I don't.
That's bullshit. Bullshit.
Why? Why do you believe it's bullshit?
I need a bullshit button. I need a bullshit button.
I need a bullshit button.
But I think it's bullshit because, like, for instance, and I'm not even gonna call this the reason why that might exist. Like, why toxic masculinity might exist. But to dive deeper, couldn't there be a such thing as toxic femininity?
So you basically is flipping it.
I'm just asking if it could exist.
It can. It can.
Why is it not a thing?
It should be. So
is
I'm
it
on
because?
The,
okay, go ahead.
Oh, so I'm on the fence with this because, okay. You know, women, we will not take accountability sometimes. We won't. I mean, it's true. And, you know, sometimes we will blame the man for everything. And then, you know. Yeah,
but sometimes it'd be our fault.
Exactly. Just like, now I'm about to go back to why all of this is happening from the beginning.
Right.
I'm going to say, because I look at religion and spirituality, so I'm going to go with the Adam and Eve.
Okay. That's an easy way to go. That's a great way
to go.
That's
a great way to go.
I would go there. I would, because that's belief. That's your belief. It's
only
what it is.
Because look at it like this. Yeah. So what you're saying is for the female toxicity, whatever you want to say it, basically it came from when she took that bite from the apple.
Holy shit, you are nailing it on the coffee.
Because first off.
Okay, I'm reloaded. Go ahead, preach.
Because okay, because when she bit that apple, she made the choice for herself, right?
And yeah.
She took the lead,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's where that comes from.
Mm-hmm.
So instead of her saying and told God, look, baby, I ate the apple, she made Adam. Adam
man,
basically
you
spoke
come
up.
Join me in this shit.
Basically, you know, and then I feel like that too is where y'all lead, because guess what? Y'all didn't say shit. Y'all didn't tell her to stop.
All right.
You feel me?
He was like, all right, I'm
so
down.
So it's kind of like that's up. Where that come from. I feel
yeah.
like,
yeah,
you know, it's...
So it is, there is some source of responsibility to be had.
It's
kind of been sort of kind of repeated in ways.
Yeah.
Like yeah. Even with the removal of the male from the nuclear family.
Yes.
Like, it's hard for things to kind of run when the government has made it so easy for things to run without them.
Exactly.
Like, it's
exactly.
just so easy.
Exactly.
Like, to not have you. So, when you fuck up once, I knew I could do better than you, nigga. I'm just gonna boss up, get a new nigga, get the little whatever I gotta get, and in between time, and it's easy, I think.
I truly believe, too, it's a two-way street where
yeah.
y'all have to come together.
100%. It's like fuck-ups everywhere.
Yes. If I'm going to say I'm wrong, you have to say you're wrong, too. And I feel like it's just in us to do that, because if we're supposed to be one and together, okay, you put the plate down, I'm going to put the plate down.
Right.
Together. Let's do this shit together.
100%.
But don't keep pointing the fucking finger. Yeah. And I feel like now
favorite point is the worst
that's
part.
Where we're at as a generation.
Yeah.
We're just pointing fucking fingers.
It's
oh,
the worst
she
part.
Did this and he did that.
Where we come up with the solution at?
Exactly.
Like, it's like, enough of the pointing fingers, but I think there just tends to be more people, I think more people in general that want to be on the more, for lack of better words, delusional side of things.
Yes.
Because
I feel like it's ego.
Maybe. I mean, and right, because it's always been like this way of living that we always live by, but at the end of the day, we know what kind of came with it. And that
exactly.
was bullshit. It was a lot of bullshit in the game.
Exactly.
In order for, oh, you know, relationships should be like our grandparents or whatever. But you know damn well it was like
they
all type of bullshit
happy.
In the game. It was all type of bullshit in the game. Side families on both halves and shit like that. He don't even know. She don't even know that family exists around the corner. But he don't even know the kid he taking care of is whoever the fucks.
But all y'all see is that y'all grandparents together.
But they stick it out.
Yes.
until y'all as a family kind of grew on up and everybody, even the grandkids, was fucking grown. They probably ain't make a move on each other.
You know? So I feel like if we all just work together, it will be amazing.
Stop trying to make it seem so easy. Like, it's mm-hmm. they make it so easy for a reason, it seems like. Like, stop trying to make it and stop trying to give it so easy.
And let's also talk about why it's toxic to stay when you know you need to leave as well.
It's a lot of times. It's a lot of times. Especially when it comes to a fucking abuse and shit of that nature. Like, you gotta get the fuck out of there. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? But if this is just, you know, it's things that are a lot smaller than that. That most relationships tend to end over. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Maybe money, mostly. You know what I'm saying? So.
No, that's true. That's true. Or just, I say leave when they cheat. Okay? Never stay when they cheat. If they keep cheating, okay, listen. It could be one cheat, okay?
You get
it could
one.
Be one cheat. And the reason I say one cheat is because everyone makes mistakes, bro. Yes, they might have not seen that shit in the time being. Okay, some people drunk. Some people don't have control of themselves when they drunk. Okay, mm-hmm. blame it on the liquor. Okay, you know, some people fuck up when they high. I mean, it is what it is. I mean, but if they constantly just fucking around and cheating, okay, now you done tell. But
yeah.
if it's that one time, he like, babe, it was just that one time. Like, I'm going to change. I'm going to... What would you do?
I mean...
What would you do if your girl did that?
If I was already fucking bitches, then it don't matter. You can go ahead and do your thing.
You see my fucking face? I'm like...
Okay, are we on that?
I'm like, huh?
I wasn't expecting that one, was you?
Do your thing, baby. I ain't mad at you.
Fuck on. Handle your shit. I'm gonna stop, because I see it's prompting you to act away. So, I'm gonna try my best. We can go to couples therapy. We can try to solve this, if it's at that point. But it be that way, like, I don't know. Anyway, we can keep it pushing and even past that.
Okay.
Because I know that you are a fellow game enthusiast. You
Yay!
Fuck
yes.
with consoles and systems and shit. Like, what you playing right now?
Yes. I'm on the PS5.
Right. What game are you fucking with?
I don't own a PS5. But I do own accounts on PS5.
Right,
so,
right.
Yeah, so I play a lot of games. I play Call of Duty. I play this is a game I'm playing right now. It's called Be Gone or something.
Okay.
It's supposed to be like some brothers with some zombie apocalypse, but you're fighting humans and zombies. So you're doing missions trying to survive. You're like attacking wolves, you're killing animals trying to survive. Like, it's shit. Sweet as hell. What else I downloaded? Oh, Halo.
I ain't play Halo a lot.
Yes, that's Xbox.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I play on the Xbox too.
Okay.
So, okay. I'm gonna be having another channel soon.
Okay.
I'm gonna be a gamer.
Nice.
Gamer.
Hey.
And I'm trying to get both systems, Xbox and PS5.
Well, make sure you come through once you launch your channels. We can talk some shit, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm thinking of doing something of a similar, because I play too much. So it's like,
yes.
You gotta do it.
Listen, it's really relaxing. I don't like when females tell they nigga to get off the game.
Oh.
Listen. Join him.
Get you a fucking account.
Join him.
Get an account.
It's so fun. Girl, like, I swear to God, he gonna eat your pussy after.
And if what? You tell me that you want to play, I'm going to go ahead and get you a system myself. Like, you know what? Fuck, I'm going to just go ahead and knock that out real quick. You know
like,
what I'm saying? You in the game.
It's so fun, Garb. Like, don't get mad at the nigga, man. I mean, I get it. Oh, 7 hours he been on that bitch. But sometimes it really be taking 7 hours because you can die. The mission will be hard as hell. You got to keep restarting the mission over. The mission was probably 30 minutes long. You gotta go from the beginning.
And you got your homeboys on with you. So as long as you can keep them, you know you might not be able to get them niggas tomorrow.
And
so we gotta go crazy right now.
And you ain't played zombies. So 100%. Zombies don't take an hour, okay? Sweetie, it takes a few. So, I mean, it's just, I feel like if you can't join them, you don't have to get rid of them. Because I wish I would be catching my shit in the freezer or outside.
You can't do it.
Because you mad I'm on the game. Like, it's not, it's impossible.
You can't do it.
But, so that's how I feel. So, I'm going to be doing this gaming. I'm definitely going to be hitting you up on that.
That's a bet.
Little Nightmares. Have you played that?
Not yet. I think I've seen it in the lobbies, but I ain't really heard too much about it.
Amazing. Okay, I played both of both. Not both. Both.
Both with F.
So, Little Nightmares 1 and 2, best games. I think it was a sequel to that, too. You got to play that.
All
right. It's amazing. It's scary as fuck. Like, it seems like it's for kids, but it scares you.
Because I heard it's like games like that, and like from what I've seen of it, it reminds me of like some, it's like a crypto fucking game out in India, some fucking where, and they got like these little Digimon, Pokemon type monsters and shit.
Oh, right,
and
right.
It's like little different creatures or whatever, and little shit running around, and they gotta get points.
It's,
and
it's
kind of like one of them addictive games.
Yes. And them games, you have to, so Little Nightmares, you have to figure it out yourself.
Yeah, nice they're puzzle
not,
games.
Yes,
yeah.
They're not, you, when you get I'm in that it. Game, it's like, I'm here you it. Go, play. Yeah. Figure out what to do.
I'm with it.
So, and I love it because it's every part of the board is touchable. So you can go look at shit and touch it and grab this and climb up that because you have to find a way. Do it.
Everything.
You know what I'm saying?
Fucking
doable. It's amazing.
But that open world shit is the shit. Like, yes. It's where game is going, man.
Oh, especially Assassin's with Creed.
Okay. No, Assassin's Creed, you know what? I ain't gonna hold you. I never got to it. Like, I think I had bought a used Xbox one time off a nigga that had it on there already.
Right.
And I'm trying to run it, like, halfway through doing shit. I'm like, I'm kind of done with it. Because it was like Splinter Cell, but it wasn't Splinter Cell. Like, it was making me just want to go play, like, the classical, like, spy stealth type games that I was kind of used to or whatever. So it was just sparking some nostalgia shit in me that made me not want to play it.
Oh, yeah.
So I never got around to it. But I like games like that, though. Platformers are cool. Platformers are cool. Because I do play a lot of Call of Duty. I ain't gonna hold you up. I'll be on Warfare.
Okay.
But I also play Warzone. I just prefer the mechanics and the way shit operates over there. It's better.
Warzone? I'm not a Warzone girl.
Nah, it'd be like that. It'd be like that.
But it's okay, because I got a lot of people and friends that keep telling me, like, just play with us. You know, join our squad. And I'm like, all right. I'm gonna have to play one day though, just to...
because they got the resurgence. Like, what changed the game for me was the resurgence, because it keeps the game shorter and shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't have to play for the fucking 2 hours worth of
true
running gun from the outside of the map inside or whatever the fuck you do, high drop or whatever. Like, it's just a lot easier to play. So that's why I fuck with the Warzone from time to time, even the new with the updates or whatever, changing the map. Everybody calling it like, oh, they made it adult Fortnite. I don't like it. And I'm like, dog, relax. It's not even, it's just a tropical setting. Like, they want to make it more, because a lot of people ain't never touched one of the motherfuckers. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, true.
So,
true.
Let's make it somewhere nobody's been before.
Mm-hmm.
Some kind of tropical shit.
I love when they do that, though.
Yeah.
Changing the maps and stuff. That's
they do it every Thursday. Be doing the update, baby. And that'd be my day off, too, most of the time. So I'd be like, all right, let me see what they did. Okay, I'm
do you do any computer games?
Not yet. I'm about to go ahead and get into the shits, but I don't know why I got tricked into signing up for Stadia or whatever. So I'm like, all right, let me see if, especially when I be at like work or something, when I be in the office, and I gotta fucking just be there. And I know I ain't got the game, because typically when I'm working from the crib, I will just crank up sticks if I ain't got too much going on, especially if I've done all of my shit, and then I know everything I'm doing is extra shit.
Mm-hmm.
I'll run the sticks for a couple seconds, and but sometimes I have to go to the office. When I'm up there, I be thinking like, damn, if I got my motherfucking even my remote or my keyboard, I can still run shit, and I should, especially because I like MMOs and shit.
Those be the most fun. Yeah, those are the funnest.
Yeah, and I know. I even got a connect that worked for Blizzard. You know what I'm saying? That's my homie and shit. That nigga from here, he one of the top niggas over there doing shit. Like, it's a bunch of niggas. Like, I be finding out all the time, the people around here, it's so much uncut gem worth of talent that people will never know that is from around here and shit. So
that's
I'm trying to get motherfuckers when they in town, come through the Wake and Bake podcast, we're gonna talk some shit, dog, about what you do, the type of shit that you into and shit, man. But yeah, man, I've been back. I got sucked back into GTA 5 because they came up with this Dr. Dre storyline.
Yes.
I got sucked back in, and I've been on it.
I came
up with my crew. Finally, I ain't even make a crew before and shit, but I'm like, all right, nigga, I'm about to start running around doing shit.
Wow. I'm jealous.
Damn. And I can't even think of the name of the damn crew. I would promote it on my own podcast. I'm going to put it in the fucking bio below.
Right.
So that y'all niggas can, the description, so that y'all can join the crew, man. I need niggas on the team to help me do this shit.
And then off the record, we going to get into that.
We can talk shit. Yeah. But, yeah. So we can get back into the music, though. My bad. You know, I think I ain't even going to say my bad because, like, I was talking to, it's my brother's sister-in-law's husband.
Okay.
And he is a listener of the podcast, one of the day ones. Shout out to my nigga Jordan, you know what I'm saying? From New York. But yeah, like he walked up and told me, like, I seen the nigga over the holidays. He's like, yeah, man. I know that y'all done started talking more nerd shit. I fuck with that, bro. I'm into that geek shit, bro. Trust me. Keep talking more of that Marvel shit. I'ma fuck with y'all niggas heavy. Trust me. I'm like, alright, my nigga.
Right.
Keep us popping in the Latin community. We talking our shit. And I think that was kind of more of our little geek type shit. Because we even explained that definition, I think, on, I think, either the last episode 46. I think it was episode 46. The card to pop up right there above the screen as soon as I say that shit. So that y'all can go back and check it out. But we pretty much broke it down to say that geek is more of like a culture of people. And nerd is like intelligent based.
Exactly.
So that was, and we were just discussing like whether or not geek culture even existed still because it's so mainstream. You know what I'm saying? So that was kind of our whole little debate. You got something to say about that? What you think?
Me? I don't know what I would. I'm more of a geek.
I know. I already know.
That's definitely me.
Because you just into certain shit. Like, certain subcultures that used to be subcultures, but they not anymore.
Right. And I just feel like everybody open, like you said, with it. So it's like, is it even? Or is it the norm?
Right.
You know?
Right. Is it normal culture?
Like, I think it is. I truly believe it is.
Like, I think.
I think we always have.
Being a geek has been normalized for a long time.
It has.
Like, people try to ostracize it, but it's not really a thing. So, that I just thought it was something for people to think about, man. We come with hot takes on this motherfucking podcast.
I actually feel like, you know, if you ain't weird or a geek, you can't be around me. Shit.
Come on, bro. It's got to be something about you that's into the, that looks at the world a little bit differently.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's what's up. Speaking of which, it's a lot of people that just don't, they not into certain music. Mostly because of what's been happening in the world. It's been different news and stories and different shit. But in the very end, because this is something that's about to come back into the news and be very popularized, regarding one of these artists I'm about to bring up, is this nigga Tory Lanez got some slap. Like, if you can separate, I'm glad you do.
I love him.
Because if you can separate the music for people from the person, then sometimes talented people, you should just let them be kind of just talented, and then when stuff happens. Or whatever.
Right.
But man, I was listening to this Tory Lanez album. It's called Alone at Prom. I don't even have it. I don't even think I have a song from it downloaded. That's some bullshit. I don't. So I'm gonna go ahead and let it play in real time because I gotta talk my shit. Hold on.
I left my love at your place today. We're too young for these incidents. Wore my heart on my sleeve too long. Going through heartbreak won't be too long. She's got my name tatted on her
breakup recently. Oh man, this is one of those. It's one of those.
Have you heard this?
No, I love it.
Oh man,
I didn't want you to
really
stop. Actually,
yeah.
Okay.
If you know, it's more weed. We can smoke and listen to shit.
Okay, cool, cool.
But this shit is. It's the whole 80s vibe style of music that I think The Weeknd more than anybody else. Like, they was trying to say Bruno Mars, but I'm like, Bruno Mars is more like 70s.
Yes,
but
yes.
I think the last project might have been like a little 80s-esque. It might have been a little 80s. Because, like, put your pinky finger to the moon. Like, that, I think that song maybe was a little 70s. Early 80s. Maybe early 80s. 70s. It might have been 79. But,
okay,
all right,
okay.
Let's agree. Disagree. Okay. It is what it is.
All right.
It is what it is. But yeah, like, I think that style of shit was popularized, though, by The Weeknd. Like, I think he was doing it kind of way before he kind of got more mainstream, too. So that's why I'm like, according to Dawn FM, the album that The Weeknd just put out, first listen, it sounds like Tory Lanez is doing The Weeknd better than The Weeknd.
Okay,
I'm
okay.
Not gonna lie to you.
You gotta play a Weeknd song now. You gotta show the difference.
Okay.
Nah, you can't do
now,
that.
There are songs that I like from The Weeknd album.
Okay.
But my whole thing is, from the top of Tory Lanez's album,
okay,
it was a go.
Gave
from the first songs, because I was I think it, I was listening to it on Apple Music, I think, because I was out. So I was listening to it on Apple Music, just the clips. I kind of like to go there just for little trailers of the songs and shit, see what it's looking like. And man, I just, hold on, wait, let me, I gotta find out which song it was that was first. Because I had bumped into a certain song first and it just turned me the fuck off. Like, I didn't really even want to continue.
Right, okay.
I know that you're hiding something from me that's been close to yours. Now I felt it creeping up every day, baby, right from the start. I know that look you give when we're fighting, we're fighting. 'Cause I used to be the one who was lying.
Rich's album did. It's like, I don't want to hear all this talking at the beginning.
Right.
And it wasn't like it was talking, but it was pretty much the equivalent of me hearing some shit like, come on, bro, hurry up.
Right.
Hurry up. I know what you're trying to do right here. Hurry up with that. So, yeah. And then once he finally picked up the pace, it kind of took off. But
okay.
I'm not as, I only listened to it once, so I don't really want to judge it like that, but I do want to put it out there in the atmosphere that it's worth a listen.
Okay.
A lot of people, especially like celebrities, are saying like otherwise. So if you take celebrities' opinions or whatever,
right,
the fuck,
right,
then maybe you should listen. So I, but it's The Weeknd, so it's like, why wouldn't you? No, honestly. So
I love The Weeknd too.
Yeah.
I'm not a go get they album type of person though. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like, I hear what's on the radio. Yeah. I hear, you know, songs that somebody might have on TikTok or something, and you'd be like, oh, okay, that's his song. Okay. But to me, I'm not an album listener no more. And I feel like,
Wow. Hold
yes,
on.
Go ahead, hit that alarm.
Wow. Don't even worry about it. I ain't got one for you yet. I'm gonna come up with one for that.
the reason why, because music is not the same. It don't touch me how music used to touch me. I'm a Eminem, Wayne listener. You know, I like lyric music. You gotta be lyrical with me. You gotta make me think and be like, what this nigga just say? Right. You know? But I don't feel like, I feel like nowadays music is more dance and drugs and hoes. Mm-hmm. And I'm not into that.
Man, I ain't gonna hold you, because that was the best of motherfucking The Weeknd. Like, he was coming, like, songs for, like, The Wicked Games.
I know! And that's
like,
the thing!
That, like, I got to the nigga because I heard Wicked Games. I'm like, this shit is amazing. Like, you can tell this nigga was like, he just sniffed the whole line or something. He got some girl in the bathtub he don't recognize because he was fucked up from the day before. Like, you can tell what this nigga was.
I'm over here like, yes.
Like, that's the type of vibe. Like, especially when it came out. Like, that was the type of time that life just happened to be on around us. Yes. You know what I'm saying? It just made it one of them songs. Like, but, yeah, man. The Weeknd was on some different shit before.
I'm on my own time. Fuck a nigga co-sign. Oh, they changed my number in my phone line. Baby girl, I don't mind.
Come on. Bro, he came with a whole little style that niggas was not really like, but he was moving that maybe to even answer our first question, is The Weeknd more responsible for the R&B artists following suit the way into the cool era of music? Because we see right now, like, Tory Lanez is pretty much mimicking what The Weeknd did in his most popular moment, and mm-hmm. I think maybe mm-hmm. has made a classic. Maybe. I don't know. But he's doing The Weeknd better than him in this album. This album,
okay,
to me,
okay, to, this
to bookend it. To bookend it all, this album, Dawn FM, to me, is a worse attempt at what the last album was.
Okay.
Like, it just sounds like he made all of the music to be for, like, a certain aesthetic.
Okay. Because I haven't heard this album.
Yeah. Like, but it's the same. It's him.
It's him.
Like, okay. If you listen to any of the last album's hits or whatever, like, any of the songs off the last album, it's pretty much, it's that type of vibe. It's just not as good of an attempt to do that again.
Okay. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, so I'm not saying it's trash.
Album, basically.
I'm
yeah,
not saying it's trash. It's another Weeknd album.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Not something to give him, like, a negative 4 on his catalog or whatever. And eventually, I think I want to get, like, a group of people together to discuss the top 5 catalogs of all time. Yeah, we come with topics like that on this bitch. We come with the heat. But I do want to talk about, so maybe it sounds a little conspiratorial, maybe it don't, maybe it do. I just want to talk some shit because I have been playing GTA a lot, and according to the definition of what an NFT is, it is what people do within that realm, which is pay for currency that's digital to pay for this fake shit that don't exist, but you own it as long as you have this account. And that's pretty much NFTs. And those things that you have made are on the blockchain, which is a part of this whole network of systems that people can run themselves at their own house if they want to. So NFTs and all of the metaverse and all that shit is like some real crazy shit I'm trying to understand, because I'm trying to get into the game. It's real early. Niggas is making some money. I'm like, where can I get in where I fit in? I think I came up with a good idea, though. I think I'm going to kill these niggas. I'm going to kill you niggas. Just wait. Just wait. But I think, like, if this is, shit, I don't even think I got, like, a name for a segment. Pothead Theory. This is Pothead Theory. I already had one. I forgot. Pothead Theory, y'all. So, I think, hold on, wait. Let me, I gotta. So, I think COVID and the whole fucking country shutting down, everything about it, the fact that now we found out it's a lot less threatening than a lot of other illnesses that are currently existing in the world. It's just like almost like a prequel. It just seems so rollouty. Like, rappers these days, All right, I got a prime example. Perfect one. In the zeitgeist, because I'm just that good of a podcaster. Gunna's album, DS4, is out currently. One of the newer releases. Didn't listen to it yet. I'll give you a review next week. He, prior to his album, he did a bunch of, like, I think what niggas in like, Jacksonville, Florida call flogging. This is flogging. I don't really know where niggas in the world use flogging at, but I think it's Jacksonville, and they say flogging. But flogging just means fraudulent, I think. I think it's just fraudulent. I think they just run it all together. Fraudulent. Flogging. I thought it was flogging, though. Like, it started with FL. So, I just think it's part of getting niggas to buy into the shit. Like, he gonna say some shit about Freddie Gibbs, talk about some, this is gonna be the biggest moment of this nigga's career, woo woo, this, that, the third, and then had like one bar about the nigga that wasn't even really like a jab. Like, right. It wasn't even really, it was like,
what is this?
I mean, you said his name.
Right.
Okay. All right. What was that? And I heard, listened to the rest of it.
You needed promotion.
But that was the only, I had to Google it. I Googled it. Like, which song was the Freddie Gibbs diss? I only wanted to hear
right.
that. I didn't even really care too much to listen to Gunna. I just do it because I'm a cat bot podcaster. If it's good, I got to talk about it. If it ain't, I don't have to.
Right.
Shit. But yeah, like, he did this whole rollout. He did this whole rollout, all talked all of this shit. And every fucking reviewer that I respect has already said, no bueno. Good attempt for the people that like you at your core. If you're trying to find new fans, it ain't it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But people that already like you are going to continue to like you. People that don't, you're probably not going to get them. And it is what it is. Maybe if I listen to it a little bit more, I'm fuck with it. But he went through all of this bullshit for some bullshit that really wasn't even part of the real shit. Because I heard it was a couple good songs on it from a couple good sources. So I'm like, you did all that shit for that. Like,
right.
You could have just dropped it. You didn't have to get into it with a Vice Lord. If he's really a Vice Lord. I don't know. Let's go quote unquote. But shout out to Freddie Gibbs. I respect that man. I heard a couple things. But anyway, so that's why I'm like, at this point in the game, COVID was literally almost like a rollout.
Yeah.
It was like a pre, before we tell you niggas, hey man, you know you can do all of that shit from in the crib, right? Most of that good shit that's prime essential jobs, like, or not even prime essential. I won't even say prime essential. I would say jobs that are catered towards the metaverse and Oculus and what they see as meta, the metaverse or whatever right. in general. Jobs that are essential to that make them easier done and done by more people and the capability to do it from home. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. those type of jobs, like, because I'm literally in that industry. And if I go on Indeed right now, majority of the jobs that I apply, I'm applying for say remote. You know what I'm saying? And still, they always, like, a lot of the people in the industry that I work in was saying that, like, oh, that's just a fad. It's going to end after 2021. It's going into it strong as fuck, niggas.
Fuck.
Like, mm-hmm. But it's a part of it. So that's why I'm like, damn. Is Facebook a part of all of this shit, man? It's too scary, man. Because that nigga be on fucking camera looking like a corpse.
The Matrix.
I promise to God, the Matrix is a real thing. And they gonna bring us into it. It's just, how do you prepare? What do you do? Like, you seen niggas was getting rich off cryptocurrency.
Mm-hmm.
So I heard that there is a company that... Okay, I talked about it earlier. They make the little characters, like, they all are original characters, but the more you capture and, like, when you breed them, I think what translates to, like, actual dollars in, like, I think one of them Southern Asian hotspot areas, like the Philippines or something, I think the game is where you can play it, and in India, I think it's, like, the only two places where you can play it right now for cash. Because it's so many of the little creatures that they make, they all NFTs. So every time you catch one, you and your original NFT create a new original NFT. You know what I'm saying? And they pay you for creating new NFTs because people will pay for those new NFTs. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of like the system of things, like the ideas that people are coming up with to make games more playable and reliable, because in order for the people to play the game, they have to buy into their currency that they use within the game.
Yep.
That makes it into the real market, like Bitcoin, and it plays against it. So based on the popularity of the game, you can make a lot of fucking money playing this fucking game based on the popularity of the game. So that's what people are doing. Like, that's where shit is, like, really moving and shit. Like, it's getting really weird. What do you think, like, could be next? Like, what do you think people, somebody could do with, because it's almost like The Sims, like, to a point.
I'm still getting into it for real. Unlocking and understanding this shit.
Yeah, it's
so
hard.
To be honest, it's so, like, I feel like you said, it came quick, but it was coming little by little. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So
it kind of hit all at once.
You know?
Yeah.
And it feel like what the fuck?
Right. But maybe it was a coincidence.
Yeah.
But it's too crazy of one.
That is. It is. It is. Definitely. Yeah, definitely.
And the very next year, Facebook goes, yo, want to do everything from home? You can do it.
They give you the side eye. You want to change?
Come on, man.
We ain't Facebook no more.
Elon Musk said that he can put a shit in your fucking brain, and he got chimpanzees playing Pong and shit, all with this little computer in their brain that is supposed to be something that is used to actually make people that can't walk, can't see, can't talk, things of that nature, do them again. If you've been paralyzed, they're gonna help you walk. They're, like, it's supposed to be some revolutionary tech.
Yeah, yeah.
But at what cost? Because, okay, you've seen all of the shit from iRobot and all the sentient, and we know that, like,
look, I'm on to all of that.
Right. They're about to start getting the cars to talk to each other using 5G technology, because the fucking street light is gonna be connected to the network and your car is connected to the network. So whenever you do some bullshit, they know, hey man, we was in range of that. What time, place, date, what the fuck your car did, what happened.
Exactly.
They know where you kind of are within the network. So it's getting more like real life matrixy, and the metaverse is like a matrix within the matrix again.
Basically.
Woo!
Basically.
God damn, did I just do something? I think I did some shit. Like, I don't know. But that's, I think that's what we moving into. That was a long ass tangent too. That ain't even part of what I'm that's fucked up. I think we're gonna skip this.
Sorry,
because
folks,
we did this whole thing right. We went to a place. But I'm gonna skip that part because I think we did the thing that we did at the beginning that was really pretty good. But I did want to know, I think there was like a certain something that started to happen within music. We back music, y'all. We back.
Keep losing it. And but we back.
No, I got timestamps now. So you can just jump ahead. If you wasn't into what was happening, we talking our shit. So did a certain era in music, like, do you think, because the 90s was filled with so much shit. And I think there had to become a time where, you know, there were songs like self-destruction, we heading for self-destruction. Like, it was like these really, like, uplifting, popular, fun songs like that really connected with the community and people really could rock with. Like, it was real good shit. And I don't think, like, outside of like Kendrick Lamar, we don't hear it like on a wide string scale. Like, I mean, because even J. Cole don't really take it like all the way there. Like, he hit you with the anti-drug message on KOD. That was fire. Don't get me wrong.
Right.
Anti-drug message is heat. But it's so many different ways that drugs are going to continue to remain in the community in so many different ways.
Because it's already in the music anyway.
It's definitely going to be in the music. But, you know, every day, people are using weed to stay sane. They smoking a blunt after they long ass day of fucking 12 hours
me,
on the shift.
Definitely.
And to avoid from going fucking crazy on niggas. Cause it's like, dog, I need to smoke
I
my little blunt. I'll be okay. I'm gonna relax and sink into the couch and relax yes. for at least an hour. And then I gotta get back to it. Be back to it. Whatever we doing, you know what I'm saying? Cause it's always something to be done. So,
yeah.
It's always something going on, and I think the bling maybe like when Cash Money and No Limit was kind of like battling it out for whoever is the most popular, who was supposed to be the most popular. Like it was almost like an entity. Pothead Theory was making these niggas go at it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And for the top spot, who's gonna be the most crazy, say the most wildest shit, be the people that really lead the younger generations leading into the future? Because what did Lil Wayne fucking do? Coming from Cash Money, Master P and them, they tried it musically, I think. But they didn't do enough long term. They didn't. Because I remember pulling up, listening with your brothers and shit, like, all the shit, because we used to, like, even with other people that was around from different blocks, mm-hmm. like, we used to all go, well, who has the CD first? Well, who has the tape
right,
first?
Right, right.
Because it started with the tapes. Like, it was like a battle. Like,
it was my mama with the tapes.
What? Woo! Where's it go? If we can talk our parents or anybody into getting those shits, let's do it. And we was always talking our shit. What? Fuck around and take the tape out, the real thing, and leave the case, replace the tape, and then show up with it. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, nigga, you ain't know. Well, where the case at? You know that ain't even yours. Yeah, fuck that shit. Nigga, what you got ain't yours either.
Right,
nigga.
Right.
Your mama bought that too, but I convinced mine. Nigga, mine wasn't
I convinced mine. Nigga, what the fuck you talking
about? Definitely wasn't gonna buy
it. She know a little.
She is not into juvenile. Trust me. Try salt. But yeah,
yes.
Like I think that whole bling era kind of was like the murder of the uplifting.
It was.
Positive
it
shit.
Was.
Because we didn't hear it again almost.
I felt like our uplifting was dance because that was our era. We were talking about white tees and lean with
having fun.
You know, we was dancing. I would see era, okay? Yep. People used to call me Sierra because all you did was dance, Briez. What the fuck? Every time I see you dancing, bro, you you know? And that's what it was. That's our uplift. Gosh. And I feel like instead of them trying to give us words of encouragement, they kind of like, well, you know, fuck it then. We just going to get them going. We just going to get them happy. You know, just dance, you know? Just,
yeah. But even through the dancing from fucking geeked up all the way to I don't really care if you cry all the way from there to there, depression, heartache, drug abuse, all that good shit was the shit. It's the shit. It's so hard to be, and that's why, you know, like, niggas talk about the Juice WRLD documentary.
Right. Did you like it?
I didn't see it.
It was depressing?
I didn't see it. I didn't want to see that shit. I seen pictures and shit.
But did you know about him? Did you know who he were?
Yeah, I heard songs that I'm like, he's obviously been screaming for this help here. Like, for quite a while. But people were obviously
drawn to it because that's how they feel,
and that's what it was. No, but but he was being supplied.
Yep, that's what it is
to keep him there. You know what I'm saying? Like that's the big story for me. Right? Yeah. They was keeping him on that level with the drugs, not telling him like, "Yo, calm down, bro. Like
right,
you could,
right.
you know, like anything was to happen." So it's like until you get the people talking around you about stuff that's better for your health, like better for you and more on an understanding level, because a lot of people haven't been there.
That's true.
So once you kind of got somebody that's been there before, it's kind of like, you know, you want to try your best to stay away from like a trauma bond or whatever, but sometimes maybe, I don't know. Trauma bonds aren't shit sometimes. I don't know. Maybe that was toxic. I don't know.
But yes, that was bonds very toxic. Lit,
but
it's okay.
Yeah. I mean, but that's what was happening. The industry turned into a trauma bond.
It did.
Oh, it did.
But you know what? I don't think I think it always been trauma bond because.
Yeah.
The stories that these artists tell back in the day,
yeah,
they not seeing that type of money that the artists now are seeing. They didn't see this type of money. No, that's facts. They even said that shit. And it's like, I feel like that time between the 70s and 2000s were the greatest music ever produced ever.
But see,
and
but here's the thing.
Stop.
It's not that, and I agree that there was a golden era. Like, it was a whole long
era.
It
was just...
And no matter what the genre was, the music kind of all around was just, like, crazy. With rap, it turned into the same thing because, like, they were always not privileged in hip-hop either. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, from the start of it. Like, it was raping them. It was killing them. Excuse me. And eventually people started blowing up on their own, but still going like, I need help from the labels though.
Yeah.
They're gonna make it easier because it's too hard. They didn't want to put together a team. They felt like the people around them wasn't capable. So they like, fuck it, I'm just let them do it. Sign what the fuck ever with all the leverage, but let them take it all because they wanted the first one. You wanted to sign the first, you don't know the first deal of business is to always turn down the first one. You turn that nigga down. Man, what? You must not know who I am, bro. I gotta go. As soon as you leave, they gonna start calling more people, and more people gonna be like, nigga, I just got a meeting with the nigga's manager today. Right. And you gonna be sick. Talking about we let him walk out. It always happens. It could happen, but they don't let it even get that far because they're afraid that they gonna lose it all. But it's like, these days, you done built the cachet. You've made yourself a name. People know who you are. You don't need them.
You don't.
Unless you just want $100,000 right quick or whatever. Like, it's stupid.
Yep.
It's stupid.
That's
you
the only way is when they want the money right away and they just so anxious and they like, okay, let me just do it to do it and just to be like, I'm signed. You know, and it'd be like, huh? It's so many independent artists out here, bro.
Yeah.
And like back then, it was not possible to be independent.
Like man, and the closest thing
did have the money.
The closest thing was damn near working for Motown because the way Motown operated, like everybody was making money from everybody else's songs. Like they were just going, yo, you go in there, we got the songwriters over there. Them niggas gonna write some shit and they might record it themselves. Who knows? Right. But guess what? If you around when they recording it, you can listen to it and go, yo, give me them lyrics. I'm about to make that same song but better.
Right.
Watch this.
For real.
And they used to just take each other's songs and remake them.
Mm-hmm.
Whoever made the best version of the song got to put it out. You know what I'm saying? So. And that just was like a revenue exchange. Every time somebody wrote a song and somebody reused, it was just recycling money through
the
company.
That's basically,
like,
because you'll hear music that,
that
you
shit
think
don't happen
in the
though.
90s or the 80s and be like, ooh, that's my shit. You'd be like, oh, where you made that song?
Right.
That was from back in
you
the
60s.
You
don't even know that's old as
50s.
No.
You know?
So and a lot of the times, the best music comes from like these writing camps. Like a lot of the people don't even talk about because I had kind of been involved with a situation or whatever. So I think I can speak from a little bit of experience. Like a lot of people don't even talk about the fact that they do bring in a lot of the older names to make them a part. Like it's almost like fuck. Somebody be mad at me. I'll hear about it eventually, but. It's almost like they bring certain ideal names that had certain like real like hit records to be a part of like those camps because they had that ideal record and the whole idea was let's bring him, make a few songs with him that's original and eventually go, yo, you know your smash, you know the one?
Right.
We gonna remake that one. We got a remake, we already did. You know
what
I'm saying?
Right.
Like, we already done cooked this up. We just need you to say, yeah.
Right.
Like, that's
waiting
how that
for you.
Yeah, that's how that should be. And eventually they say, yeah, and we got a new remake from some unknown fucking singer from speaking of the bling era in general, we usually do a battle of the albums here.
Okay.
So, pretty much taking two albums. The first one we did was, okay, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. So, our listeners know that the last three episodes is supposed to be a fourth. That fourth one does not exist because of me. I was negligent with the system. Did not do what I was supposed to do. It's my fault. So, we've been sprinkling the content from that into other episodes. And I think we didn't do that prerequisite little section of the bling era thing before. So, that's why this is lit.
Okay.
And we come with 400 Degreez versus 500 Degreez. Mm. Yeah. Juvenile, Lil Wayne. These two albums were something that they kind of just have things that kind of lived on throughout time and did some like real monumental crazy shit.
I cannot pick.
You don't have to.
All we gonna do is
discuss. That's all we here to do is discuss. It ain't gonna take us that long.
Cause I am a huge,
Cash Money
Hot Boys fan.
The album eventually going 4 times platinum,
and I'm only 29, guys. So
right,
therefore, I know good music.
Was on the Rolling Stone, top 500 greatest albums of all time, 470. You know what I'm saying? It was kind of high up there, but I don't blame them. It's worth it. Just being on that list is a big attribution. Singles included Follow Me Now and Ha and Back That Thing Up. Come the fuck on, dog. There's not a lot of niggas that can really compete with this shit, bro.
Ooh,
I'm telling you. And it's...
Y'all mamas is still twerking to that Back That Ass Up, though.
It's really motherfucking hot right now. Because 400 Degreez right now. It's only 400 Degreez right now. And this is what we on. And it start real early with Ha. We get to hear a little Matty Fresh talking some shit. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, you got to get yours. Then Gone Ride With Me was kind of like an okay song. I really, really didn't fuck with it as much at the time. Maybe a little bit later. But it really started getting crazy around Ghetto Children. And then we get Follow Me Now. And then we start getting the rest of everything that started coming behind that. And it get a little crazy because it eventually get to Rich Niggas.
Uh-huh.
And Rich Niggas was kind of like almost like the highlight of the whole shit. Because, you know, that was that motherfucking, nigga, that's my life. When I pull up in that truck, shawty, that's my right. Bling, bling. Look, he even said bling, bling in the song. That's the first time niggas even heard it. Come on, Top Potter.
Where y'all think Ice and all that came from? All this jewelry.
Come on.
All this Ice.
Come on, came straight from Cash Money. They already then gave us the whole, they gave us the whole sauce for the way the game was about to go.
You better run for it, next run for it,
run. What, man, they had shit on this motherfucker, bro. And Back That Ass Up, of course, one of the top hits.
Your grandma, woo, will still be dancing to this, woo, bro.
Woo. And they had 400 Degreez on here, though. Wow, meow, me. They got playing in the background.
I'll bust your ass up.
Like, it was just the most gangster shit that we had. It was in a long time. That we
it's
had
taking
heard.
Me back to a summer. I gotta stop.
Man, I'm telling you, it puts you in a place. It puts you in a place. You lucky I ain't decided to play none of it, but.
Right.
It makes the video not worth nothing as a whole. But I love playing the music doing it. It just works. But so, and we even had the Ha remix from Hov himself on this one.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So this shit was just a whole experience that niggas just was not expecting from the South. And we wasn't expecting Hov to jump on some shit like that. So it was like the nod, almost. Letting niggas know he was next. But then we got 500 Degreez. That kind of was a lot later down the line when it comes to releases on Cash Money, but it eventually dropped. Inspired by 400 Degreez, of course. Was it animosity based that he dropped it? Who knows? It just seemed like a competition thing, though. I think they was breeding that type of environment. Yo, shit was hot, but I'm about to make something hotter than that.
Right.
500 Degreez.
Go up.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure that's how it happened, but when he dropped, first week, 141,000 copies. More than lackluster for a release of his acclaim, because it was technically like his sophomore album. Yeah, it was his sophomore album, because Lights Out had already dropped in 2000. He took two fucking whole years, and this is what he came back with. And, do you remember Way of Life? Because it's the way of life.
Oh, yes.
And I want it all. And I'm spending. Oh, baby. Can't stop the sun. No. That's exactly what I mean by niggas used to get niggas in them writer camps. He used to be like, cuz, you want to redo your shit? Like, let's do this shit right quick, cuz. We're going to take you off it, though. We're going to take you off, cuz. You don't need to be on it, nigga. We're going to put my homie TQ on now. But yeah, man, that was kind of like the start. Cause look at me and fly talking. Come on, man. They was just trying to show off big timers and what they were doing. You know what I'm saying? They kind of was like the fuel to majority of the good shit. Of course, Manny Fresh. But
I could vote nine if I wanted to now. Cause this album.
Just looking at it. Look what you looking
this
at.
This one.
What you?
I don't think I really liked this album.
Ah, look.
And I love Wayne, you know?
He had Blood.
Lights Out was just that one.
He had 500 Degreez wasn't even that. But he did have Young and Blues. That was my shit. Young and Blues, yeah. I ain't gonna hold you up. That's song 14 before I even like caught one that's really. But Bloodline, though, lives. Where You at the time was great. Like, he had songs on here that was popping.
Yeah, definitely.
But it was too many misses.
That's what it was.
Too many misses.
So, it's, you know, one of them albums that you just, it's only five songs, it's 21. I don't want it to get that album out.
And it got voted. It got voted really high. Like, 4 stars from All Music, 3 from Hip Hop DX. I fuck with Hip Hop DX.
It was still a great album.
It was good at the time. At the time, it didn't live well. It didn't live well.
So I'm gonna go with 400 Degreez. Stop playing.
God damn.
Stop playing with my boo.
And I ain't even gonna front. I totally agree. I agree.
Finish him.
You know? It's
done. Sorry, Wayne. You definitely didn't take the challenge that you fucking made. Nobody told you to go make an album called 500 Degreez. You made it a challenge and you fucking lost it. Yeah. Nobody in hip hop ever heard that take. Because nobody's ever even made it.
Love you, Wayne. But.
Yeah, man. Yeah. That wasn't the one. It was right before you started to go crazy on niggas. You took that 2-year vacation. You started making them squad up mixtapes. Whoever you was around at the time, the whole kid, and all them niggas. Man, you gotta go back and listen to the Carolina Blue Kicks, Carolina Blue Chick, Carolina Blue Gators, Carolina. He went crazy. Oh, fuck it. My favorite team is the Lakers. That nigga went crazy on that Maya and Jay-Z shit. Like, the best of me freestyle. That used to be my shit. Like, so he kind of went on the warpath from there. Like, he figured out he lost.
Yeah.
Figured out he lost.
Because, I mean, 400 Degreez.
Go forever
Juvie,
live
you did
in
that.
Our hearts.
You did that, Juvie.
That's gonna forever live in our hearts. In clubs near you for the rest of your life.
Right, my right.
Oh, yeah, I'm glad you could come through and talk a little bit of shit.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, because I don't think I got nothing more. And I didn't have you for an hour and 20. You know what I'm saying?
Cool. So cool. Look, Andre never texted back because he knew what the fuck it was. Duh.
So yeah, it be like that. So,
and this is my first. I was a little nervous because I didn't know what was going on. I didn't know if it was like you could cut stuff out. I can, you know. Yeah, I'm like, what should I say? What should I say? Nah, no, next time. So it could be that.
Try not to the most of the time. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And that's why the certain shit that comes in handy when it's happening.
Yeah.
And once you have done it enough with certain people on certain platforms that got certain, you know, because certain people don't play music or whatever, but I be feeling certain ways. So I just be wanting to get points off without getting the point off without saying it. Like,
exactly. Music don't do it. Okay, cool. That's dope, though.
Yeah.
Yes. So,
you eventually come up with a little mojo, a little flow, and everybody don't do it the same. Some people, they got a format, but I don't like that shit. It should kind of be a little bit natural, and it should be like maybe like a structure to the beginning, how you introduce yourself, and then maybe a little bit something how you get, you know, in the show. And then maybe something about the show that makes it sort of original. And one of the things that we didn't do in on this episode 47, is it a classic? Okay. If you want to, we could take a couple seconds and brainstorm an album that we both know really well, or an artist's discography, and then we can go through either the discography or just the album, and then just go, okay, it's a questionable classic from at least like 7 to 11 years ago.
Okay.
Like, it got to be somewhere in there, the album that we both remember, R&B or rap. We did a lot of the rappers, yeah, kind of like by catalog. So we can go R&B if you want to.
We can do both.
Yeah, it's up to you, man.
I'm music.
Just let me, I'm here. And we're going to chop, like I said, like we're going to take this whole thing and chop it up into pieces. I usually put out the episode first as a whole. Some niggas like to listen to it like that at work or shit like that.
Okay, cool. Yay.
So, yeah.
This was fun. So.
What's up? What you about to say? Give what you got going on right now. What's popping with you? I actually chopped this out and put it sooner so that whatever fuck you got popping.
Cause I don't know. What do you do music wise? Like, is this your studio? That's what I
not
was wondering.
Really?
Cause I fucked with y'all. Listen.
Okay. Yeah.
I fucked with
it. That's what the fuck is up.
It was a whole play. I just let it play.
Yeah, no. Listeners know, Cold Cause 2021. We had to re-put it out. It was a re-release. A lot of people didn't hear because I had heard certain things about the way that the algorithms work. So I'm like, all right, I'm gonna make it YouTube content, and then, you know, eventually people find out that it exists and it's the only place, so I'll be able to centralize shit kind of, but. That was the original thought. And then I'm like, all right, eventually I got to take it somewhere else. Yeah. That's like a link that I can put and you know, make a better cover. Cause the cover wasn't as good either. So I'm like, all right, let me make a better cover.
Really?
I made the cover myself. I'm like, this ain't really that sweet of a cover, so I'm going to make a new one.
I don't know why I thought it was dope. I thought it was dope.
Not that one. Not the 2021. Okay. 2020, the original one that I had put out, it was only five.
Oh, so that's why.
It was like five or six songs, right?
I don't remember that one.
Yes, nobody do. It only got a certain amount of views. That's why I'm like, all right, let me re-release it. You know, redo everything. I'm gonna put some more songs on it that I just released this year in 2021. And
I've noticed that people do that. They'll take old songs that didn't really get the look or the quality that they wanted to get, and then remake it or redo it somehow. Sometimes they don't even have to redo it. They just put it out, and then they'll drop a video with it.
Mm-hmm.
And boom, everybody watching be like, damn, this new, be like, and people be like, nigga, this tight. Was 50.
It'd be like, it's tight, and it'd be like, I didn't even hear it. And it's like, old to me, New York.
Cause I was thinking about doing that one time with my music.
Why not?
I've dropped the song, but I want to redo the song.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to switch up the whole chorus, the hook, and then.
The remake be hard, trust me. And say fuck it, cause it's probably people out there that like the first one, so remake it, call it part two. Fuck it, it's part
two. You feel
two.
Me? And I was thinking that. I'm like, could that go though? Could I sell that? You know how you be.
Mm-hmm.
So I could. Okay.
I already know how I go. But that's exactly what you do. That's exactly what I've done.
Okay.
Like, 5D is very old, but it holds weight. It's just content, it's certain content that's good like that. And if it do hold the weight like that, when you put it back out there and start running around, I didn't even run around because it was COVID.
Right.
I kind of was just feeling some shit. And every now and then, I would call niggas to, like, pull up at, you know, my girl at the crib, at the time crib or whatever, right. You know what I'm saying? Because she was living downtown. it was a whole fucking different little vibe down there. So I'm like, oh yeah, we record down this bitch. And I don't know no studios but Mike Seeger. Okay. And Mike Seeger fucking expensive as fuck. So I only go down there when I'm doing certain type of music. I knew this was gonna be some mixtape type shit, so I just was bringing, and I recorded Bitcoin, shit like that, all just over her crib. And damn, sometimes I was getting Dale to pull up at Silent Let's Riot around the corner. Cool. Yeah. No, I some of the shit I was getting exterior mixed on, but some of that shit I wasn't. I was just letting that shit go. Fuck that shit. Because Dale was doing it. Whenever Dale do that shit, he's around the corner. He's a fucking magician. Like, your rough mix, you be feeling confident as fuck, because I'll run it through the bigs, and I listen to it in my headphones. I'm like, oh, this is actually, like, ready. Like, I don't even need anybody to touch this. Like,
right.
I can put it out today. So, that, it happens. You right. know what I'm saying? And I know you probably got some shit like that as well. So, put that shit out. Yeah, do that shit. Like, repackage it. Make it something else.
Because I don't want to rap. Because, okay, this is my thing.
Okay.
People ask
okay,
me.
Okay, yes. Get, let's
people
get to the shit.
People have asked me.
Okay, I'll reload it.
Come on. So people have asked me, what have I done and where have I been when it came to my music?
Okay.
So the thing is, I'm not trying to be a celebrity. I'm not trying to get my music on the radio. Mm-hmm. I have a message. When I make music, it's because of what I love. I just love music, so I like to make it. You know what I'm saying? So it's not about,
of course,
oh, I'm making music to get this money, or, you know, or trying to be famous, or trying to, no, I'm just really just putting out projects. You know what I'm saying? I'm not expecting anything from them. I'm not expecting people to share them.
Having
or go
a
crazy.
Blast, cause you
yeah,
felt something.
You know?
When you heard a beat, you felt
yes.
some shit.
I want to just
I gotta get this off.
Yes, you yeah. know? And that's how I feel with music. And if it yeah. gets big, how it gets, then that's how it is. And a lot of people were telling me, like, because I'm from Inktown, Inkster, stand up.
Hey.
They all was telling me, like, we miss you, bro. Like, what the fuck? Like, it's people out here rapping, but they ain't chill. You know
I've had
man?
Discussions in certain circles where people was like, hey, man, you know, Bria. I'm like, Breeze, what you mean? I remember. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah,
I think I did one of your first fucking photo shoots. Like, that shit was fire. We got some
fire
shots.
Fire as
shots.
Fuck.
Like,
yo,
we got some
I
good
still
shots.
Got them.
Yeah, those are good.
You know me? And so I'm just, right now, I'm going to get back into that.
Yep.
I got into a car accident, guys, in 2019. Mm. And I had two knee surgeries, both knees. And I had back surgery in October. So I'm recovering. I'm doing well. I'm going to be better than ever. I've been writing. I actually know a few people with studios and video editing, all of that. So I'll be coming back, dropping videos, and I feel like that's when I'm going to come back. I'm not going to tell dates. I'm going to just surprise you. And I'm just going to just drop projects each time, and it's going to be videos.
Right. Yeah, that visual is important.
Mm-hmm.
It's important.
That's it, because I'm going to talk to y'all. I gotta tell y'all something.
Yeah, that's the way that life is kind of moving these days. People want to see with they want the visuals with the audio at the same time.
Yep.
So it works better that way. It just made the music hit a different type of way for the people that's hearing it for the first time. But yeah, no, that's why different platforms like the TikToks and the everything
yes.
that's coming out is really useful and important. Once you can manipulate and figure out how it works, then you can really use it to your advantage. Like, very short clips actually tend to be some of the most watched shit, but what did you put in those couple seconds that's the most popular? I think it's like 3 seconds.
Yeah.
Be popping. And it's,
that's
what did
it.
You put there?
Right, right.
That's fire. Like, you gotta just know. Getting in this new era, it's so easy to kind of get adjusted almost. They kind of make it easy because they even paying people now. Like, Instagram is trying to compete with TikTok, so they paying people to be top creators, quote unquote.
That's true. That shit is insane.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's so much money out here to be made through social media. It's ridiculous.
Not just social media, but gaming.
That, but I'm just saying, yeah.
Video
just,
games. Like, they it really everything.
That
but
social.
Right, it's because it's Twitch.
Yep.
Like,
yep.
It's just so much happening right now that is really prompting humanity to be a certain way. And pothead theory, I don't know. Is it prompting people to really do fire shit? I don't know. Because the art ain't really been super duper fire or whatever for me to be going like, this is what the best time to be alive. But at the same time, these are the movies. They're remaking a bunch of shit. And that's kind of getting repetitive, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just certain things about going into this new future that I feel like we lacking so much of. It's like, it was just going to be, like, good for humanity. I don't fucking know.
I don't think it will be. I know we have to adapt to things, and I get it, you know. Because just like our grandparents, they will probably look at us like, oh, with our phones, they like, what the fuck are those?
Yeah.
They still look at that like that's crazy. So I know that we have to adapt, but the way we're adapting, it's not good because we're becoming lazy.
Yeah. But so much of a bad thing, like when it comes to certain areas, like not having to remember something and still be able to answer the question. Like, you don't have to remember it, you kind of just have the information. It's like having a knowledge,
that's not good. That's a part of life, of who you are as a person, as a being, like your memory, your, you know,
if that's what you're processed to do.
Yeah.
I think if that's the type of shit you're on and the type of time you want, and that's what's going to be useful for your life in general, you're going to be good at it. Like, it's going to be a God-given gift for a reason. You're going to know what your God-given gifts are, I think. I'm sorry to cut into you like that.
It's okay. It's okay.
I think that is something to be considered on the real. Like, people don't think about it from that perspective. Like, maybe you don't have that because it's not necessary for what you are being used to do.
Right,
and
right.
For the Lord's name. You know what I'm saying? Okay, all right. So, we were gonna do is a classic, but I had something written down that we didn't really get to for. And so, without my nigga Bones being here, it really changes the dynamic, but I think I'm gonna try to argue from, like, a blend of both of maybe what both of us maybe would maybe say. Say maybe that many times, too. But question kind of at hand is, do women tend to keep as many friends as their male counterparts? And I don't really think it's the case. Y'all sort of get mad at each other for the very simplest reasons. Somebody could miss a birthday.
That's true.
Somebody could not call in a while. Like, it's just certain things that y'all require of your, like, real immediate best friends gotta kind of happen. And it's not the same with guys. Like, we don't need as much of that.
I know, I get that. I definitely get that.
That's why I think more of us have more of the people from back then than y'all. Like, how many you
have? Oh, that's true. That's true as fuck. Because,
like, you can name off hands.
I got one.
Let's go. That's
one girlfriend. And then the girlfriend. Rest
girl.
Are guy friends. Because
Don't count.
They do count.
Don't count.
They do count. Because I've never fucked them. They don't like me. I don't like them.
It do not matter.
They're my friends.
I'm being very honest.
Listen to me.
It don't matter.
They are my friends.
Okay.
They've been my friends since elementary.
Yeah.
And middle school.
For sure.
So.
You're good people. You're good people. You are great people.
Okay,
amazing company. Great conversationalist. We've been talking for a while.
That's it, though. But as a girlfriend, as girls, just one. So you're right. But I can't say that's every girl, because other girls do have a lot of friends that they grew up with, that they're still friends with. Mm-hmm. Good friends. And I'm like, damn, bitch, I wish I had that many goddamn friends left, but life happens.
Yeah.
You know?
It does. But all I know is, whenever any woman in the world wants to run the social experiment, it's the social experiment, it's the one. Send a text. Tell them, hey, slide through on me. And send it at 2 a.m. or whatever. Do it. I dare you. I double dog dare you. Do it. See what he says.
Mm-mm.
I'm not going to answer that.
You know why?
I'm just going to say that.
You know why?
I'm just going to say that.
You know why? I'm just not that type. I'm not gonna do it. And I know my friends, they have relationships. And I know that they live with their women. So why would I do that?
See, look, you are different. You are the exception to the rule. That's not, and everybody's the exception to the rule when it comes to certain things. Everybody's the exception. So we can all find examples of why that wouldn't be, but I think it's just okay. It is what it is. If that person's circumstances was the, look, I can change the terms too. Mm-hmm. If that person's circumstances was the change and it wasn't the case that, you know,
they probably would look at me like, Bria, what?
They would be like, come through.
I don't know. And then they'll be texting like,
I mean, I think you're tripping right now.
When they're texting that, guess what they're gonna be doing?
That's what they're gonna be doing.
They're gonna be thinking something.
They're gonna be in the shower getting ready, like, yo, yes.
No,
it's
no,
happening.
No.
It's happening. It's happening. They're gonna be talking to their boys, group chat. Boop. Hey, it's a go. It's happening. You don't even know. I ain't even gonna tell you what's happening.
Why do you think that would happen?
I ain't even gonna tell y'all what's happening. I'm gonna just tell y'all it's happening.
Why do you think that would happen? Why would you think that would be his response?
It's in most men's nature to want an attractive woman to have sex with them.
Ah, see, you make me not want to be attractive. Because
it don't matter. Anybody's attractive to anybody. Like, people have certain things that they like about certain people that make them attractive to them. It don't even matter what level or scale. Like, men, it's not that.
So y'all can't have
girlfriends?
I don't
think it's hard to please. I don't think it's.
Because you're saying to me.
I think
if my friend is attractive,
we ain't
fucking friends.
I think that it is possible, especially when y'all live in like a realm of, we already have an established everything. Like, everything is kind of here. We are who we are. We've been for a long ass time. So it is what it is. Like,
right,
I'm not calling you every single day to see what you're doing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
that's not my, yeah.
We not like besties or whatever. Like, right. You know what I'm saying? Like, we talk every now and then. We say, yo, what's popping? What's going on? Okay, what you doing? Okay,
right.
Cool. All right, bet. All right. You know what I'm saying? Like, it is what it is. Like, it is platonic.
No, seriously. I get what you're saying.
It's platonic.
Because yeah, I don't talk to my friends every day, especially my guy friends, because guess what? They live with their women. Why am I hitting you up every fucking day?
Mm-hmm.
So that's a thing that's mm-hmm. between me, because I have mm-hmm. respect. And I let it be known before then. Like, these niggas know that they will never hit this. And that they've never hit this. And any guy that ever been my friend never fucked me.
Mm-hmm.
And if there's a rumor out there,
I don't know one.
That's just them on they dick and on they time. You feel me? Because I let it be known. Like, yes, I'm a flirt. I flirt with people. I let guys know that they're handsome. I tell women that they're beautiful, because guess what? I like to uplift people, mm-hmm. especially our black kings and queens. I like to see us high, happy as hell. So I like to compliment each other.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, I'm a flirt with you and everything, but you're not fucking me, and you know that. You feel me? So when I say I got a friend and I got guy friends, that's what they are. They just friends. Like, they ask me about, yeah, because they be telling me about how they bitches be tripping and asking me, like, you know, bro, what should I do? And I be like, listen, bro, don't do nothing stupid. She mean this, because they just trying to understand from their perspective.
I'm just saying, 8 out of 10 gonna fail.
They are, though. They are. Definitely. Because listen,
niggas gonna fail.
I've had friends. Literally, guy friends that I had to cut off completely, because it went from friends, besties, to, nah, Bria, I really want you. Like, I've been wanting you since this. And I just be like, oh, what? And it feels different afterwards, because it's like, my nigga, I had in my mind that you my friend, and you looking at me like that, I should punch you in your shit, nigga. I invited you up. Bitch, I should kill you right now. But it is what it is, like you said. I mean, but and then it's other people that really just, you know, they know how to just be your friend, and that's what it is.
Part of, I think, it's just part of life.
Yeah.
It is what it is, but like I said, the math, I want to maybe do the shit one day, get a couple people,
okay.
and do it across a couple different people. Like,
okay.
Just to make it not the same 8, just a solid 8. I mean, right. a solid 10. Get the solid 10 calls and see what exactly happened. Record the whole thing, just let it run.
Right.
Just let it run. Right. We got, and we gonna put a camera on your phone. We gonna start it with texts. Okay. Start it with texts.
Just send them a, we gonna send a response.
Okay. Let the little clouds pop up. Oh, you said, oh shit, this nigga got green dots. Oh shit. What's happening right now? Is he losing points for his green dots? Is
wide awake.
2 a.m. What was popping? First minute. Yeah.
And you know what I do? My phone go on do not disturb at 10:30.
Oh, that's fire. Yeah.
Swear to God. People are be, you, oh, I wait. Called you. You can't call me.
So are you in a relationship?
No, I am not.
Okay. No. Okay. That it be like that. It's yeah. Certain things happen. It's since 2020, the world went crazy. Almost.
Basically.
I think the world went crazy. Mm-hmm. I think everybody got a little bit of something that is like trauma from what happened. Because it was too much. Yeah. It was too much. And it's still a little bit too much. They're trying to, it's too much for them. But what can we do? We moving into the metaverse. Maybe one day
women will admit that they don't keep their friends for as long as men. Maybe eventually.
I'm admitting that. Okay. I'm one of them.
So you do think that? I'm hoping that they don't think that, because it ain't true.
It's not true. Not true. But we'll say so. Give me, okay, do you have a dating app experience? Anything that's happened to you? Like maybe something that you just don't, you want to recommend people watch out for? Just something crazy?
Yes, actually.
The person themselves.
My last relationship that I just got out of was, you know, through a dating app.
I think it's like 50% of people, I think,
and,
out there.
Look, it's embarrassing to even talk about because the experience.
If you bag somebody off social, that's the same shit, though.
It is, you know, and I feel like that's what it was. And do I recommend it? No, because I feel like, well, no. I'm not going to say no. I'm going to say do you. Mm. But if that person turns out to be different from what they show, you know, then that's, you know, that's on you. That's you to decide, you know. Yeah. But, and that's what I, that was what happened with me, you know. So, yeah. So I wouldn't do it again. Hell no. I need to see you in person. I mean, you gotta walk up always, and send me into the stuff.
People got like a double identity. Like, I get it. But even the person that meet you in person, come on. We was from that era. We was from the in real life era. Like, we was meeting people out in the world. Like,
and that's what I'm saying, yeah.
People were still fucking dickheads. Like, women and men, well, younger women and men were still cheating on each other. And it just was what it was. Like, it was life. And it is what it is because, oh, bringing shit full circle. Check it out. Because toxic femininity exists and it was promoting men to be toxic. What's happening when something occur out in the streets? Maybe almost the slightest disrespect from some women can cause her to go, you gonna let them pull that off? And it really ain't even shit. It's nothing. But now I have to beat this nigga the fuck up because my girl is not gonna respect me anymore. If I don't,
wait a second.
You find yourself being sorry for this nigga. Like, I gotta beat the fuck out this nigga now. Cause my girl not gonna respect me anymore if I don't. So, come here, nigga. Let me pound your fucking face. Merry Fistmas.
Okay. I'm not that type. So, I can't speak for every woman. Okay. Because every woman do that.
So, I'm not saying it's you. I'm glad you made it clear.
Okay.
But does that exist in the world?
It does exist. That does exist.
Different behaviors. And I can name more than just like occasions like that mm-hmm. that kind of promote men to be their worst selves in the extent.
So are you blaming?
I'm just saying it exists. I'm not saying it's the source.
Okay.
Never said it was the source. I just wanted you to admit it existed. That was the conversation.
Okay.
That was it. Don't try to trick me. I've been potting for a while.
I'm not.
I can talk.
I'm just laughing because this is funny.
But it makes you think. It just makes you think.
Okay.
we are responsible for each other's bad behavior.
That is true. That is true.
We do it to each other, like, throughout the trip, throughout life. We find out people who aren't who they say they are in our earliest relationships. A lot of people don't want to admit on the record they was dating pretty much from 14 up. Nobody wants to admit it started at 14, but it usually start around there. And then you start really kind of dating and you see that people aren't who they say they are. Like, I went through my trials and tribulations with being this unfaithful in the 10th grade. First little try at cheating and shit. You know what I'm saying? I was dating this young lady. We actually were on each other's podcast and I would drop her shit right in here because we talked about all of that shit. And it was my first attempt and I'm like, all right, I'm not good at this. I'm not really fucking good at cheating. So I'm not even really gonna try to do too much of this because it's gonna be a lot of work even trying to hide it. Like, literally, no, like, hey, literally, I'm in the hallway kissing the one girl, forgetting that the other girl, who was the older girl, had the car. She was kind of like usually late. So I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, boom. I got most of my classes with her, so we can go like that, boom. Right. And then I got caught up. She was there early. I'm tonguing her down right there in the middle of the hallway. She walking past like, oh, I'm just a car?
Right.
Yeah. Fuck, you at the wheel. Like, that was a thing since a kid.
Okay.
Men has done that since they were children. You ain't got onto the game yet.
Oh, listen. I know.
Gotta be aware. It's like I said. So, when women talk that like I was tricked, shit, I be like, it's bullshit. Learn that lesson already.
Yeah.
You learned it already.
Okay, no. Let me go back.
Let me go back.
Because you can be tricked.
You can be. You can voluntarily be tricked too. Huh? We potty. We potty. Come on.
Yes.
So that's all I'm saying. Like, it's different things that we gotta just, as long as we can start going, I should be held accountable for part I played in the negative way that she's been reacting to what I've been doing, but she hasn't even been catching me doing shit, but I've been doing shit, and that's been making her even investigate it.
Right. Yeah.
Now she feels inadequate, all type of other shit, because I am fucking around. She just ain't found out. I'm just good at it. Let me continue the sentence. I'm about to say, let me continue the sentence. Good at it.
There we go.
But yeah, like, those scenarios happen. Like, those situations, people, places, things, nouns, adverbs, and y'all know what the fuck I'm saying right now. I'm hot. I'm about to roll up again too. But yeah, it's a lot going on in the world. I don't know about any like current events. I've been trying not to talk about current events as much as possible, so this content can live forever. Like, people can always just come back to like wild dating app experience and go, I agree, Alan. Can't fucking relate to that. We don't know nothing. We are Vaseline people and petroleum jelly from the nearest bodega people. And I don't even live in New York. But
what do you know about Carmack?
Yikes. Yo, whoa.
I'm asking you a question, that's all.
I wish Carmack would pay us some money. That's what I know. We have been trying to get some people that own some places things to give us some money. So shout out to all of the people that make weed strains themselves. We are looking for you.
Yes.
If you got an original strain, we will smoke it and tell people that either it's good or bad. We might trash your shit. Because we do music reviews. I'm not even going to hold you up. What? And we do music reviews too.
What?
So people can send in their music.
Nice.
We can review it. They got to pay us a couple dollars, you know what I'm saying? But we're going to talk about it on the show in the long form. We're going to cut it out as a link, as a clip.
That's
and it's going to be a part of the whole shit. And if it's heat, your shit is going to live forever in our library.
Right.
And
nice.
If it's not,
nice.
It's going to live forever in our library.
Especially with the strain.
But yes, strains can definitely get reviewed. Because I know certain strains come from certain dispensaries in the area.
True.
So, if I say a strain and my people say, yo, we not going, I'm changing dispensaries because we not fucking with that strain no more. Don't say I didn't tell you you can call me and I didn't call you directly because you didn't listen to this podcast. I don't know. But yes, we would love for brands to reach out. We got a couple people to listen. You might have them come your way, especially musicians, because I've done some musical stuff that people think is, you know, feats, I guess. I guess eventually we can do a fucking Is It A Classic if you got the time. I can't think of nobody. I just kind of went to an R&B channel. I think it's a bunch of new shit.
Ooh.
You like, I want to hear this.
I do. See, I'm going to have to pick a day then.